Okay, thank you very much. So, yeah, it's my great pleasure that I can make a talk in this great opportunities. Okay, so I'd like to thank the organizers. I'm Hideyuki Okano, I'm from KU University School of Medicine, and the Riken Center for Brain Science. Actually, I'm also visiting a professor at my institute, MIT. Okay, today I'm going to talk about brain mapping and disease modeling and using genetically modified marmoset that is supported in brain mice. Okay, so marmoset is our favorite model system. It's a small neural primate. It has long lifespan, around 15 years, but their sexual maturation is early, 1.5 years. They have high reproductive efficiency, and they show a unique set of social interaction behaviors, such as food sharing, formation of family unit, and cooperative breeding. The advantage of marmoset include the availability of genetically modification technologies, and also the whole genome sequencing information, and brain-wide connectivity map. Actually, so we made so marmoset brain MRI database open to the public last year through this QR code. Please can try this QR code. And so so we have the data, a huge amount of data of the structural MRI and the diffusion MRI and the resting state MRI using this 9.4 Tesla MRI machines. So both in the live brain and post-mortem brains. And so this is an example of the ex vivo MRI, and you can see that there are very fine morphology for the marmoset brains. And also we have developed a standard brain space through this data. And so but we could share the standard quantitative 3D data, and so we overlaid the various data in this space. Actually, so anterograde and retrograde tracer data, and also the NISU staining data and gene spatial data, and so diffusion MRI data were incorporated standard brain space, and we developed the database. And we also incorporated the in situ hybridization database, okay, so we called the marmoset gene atlas, that is led by the Tomomi Shimogori lab in Riken CBS. So you can have you can search the gene expression, and you can search by the name of the gene list or the gene name or the disease and the region and the fine structures. Since 2016, almost 3,000 in situ hybridization data are registered, and we update every 2 weeks. So we have created an integrated comprehensive database of the marmoset brain structure and gene expressions. This database will serve as a reference data to detect abnormality in the disease marmoset models. And so it will also aid individual studies and support interspecies comparisons. So data include that, so MRI, structure and connectivity, and tracer injection data, and gene expression data, such as in situ hybridizations, and it will be integrated in the standard brain space. And so this will be the world's first comprehensive and integrated non-human primate brain database. Okay, so as regards the tracer data, so we have used the AAV vectors expressing fluorescence proteins. This virus was injected particular site in the by stereotactic injections. The axon projection was traced through the high throughput neurophysiology pipeline or serial two proton tomography by using the tissue site. And so this data was registered with MRI data. So by this way, so we have created a prefrontal cortex high density map. So through that tracer injection, and so the tissue was processed by tissue site, and so imaging analysis pipeline have been developed. And so we injected 44 sites in the 19 areas. And so we revealed that the feature of the prefrontal cortex database as follows. The first, the high density images that cover entire the brains, and and so high density accurate 3D constructions, and they have high dynamic ranges, very strong the regional connection or the broad and weak connections. Okay, so through this analysis, we discovered six issues. So we discovered domain-specific columnar projection like this, and also discovered column-level bidirectional connections. We also discovered topographic connections between a higher the association cortex. For example, between the prefrontal cortex and the cingulate and prefrontal cortex and the temporal. And so we quantitated the analysis of the diffuse and weak and the projection. And so columnar projection was likely to be species selective. this was okay, rarely observed in mouse, and so we have done the quantitative analysis of layer-specific projections. And so we recently published this result in Neuron, but we also provided the prefrontal cortex connectome data made public by the web views. So you can view the data from the Zoom's sections of viewers. This is a high resolution section viewer, and also flat map viewers, and we can take a look at the connection metrics, and also standardized the data viewers. It's the high resolution and section viewers, like the Google Map or the brain images. And so as regards its clinical applications, so we collaborated group with the European neurosurgeon studying the deep brain stimulation technique for the treatment of depressions. So neural pathways are from the prefrontal cortex to the subcortical structures such as the ventral tegmental area and subthalamic nucleus were identified and compared to the human MRI data. Okay, so as regards the very important advantages of Marmoset availability of genetic modifications. In 2009, we published Nature papers by the developing the transgenic technique in Marmoset by range virus mediated gene transfers. In 2016, we have generated knockout Marmoset by genome editing, and this year we could publish on the knock-in Marmoset. We generated a tyrosine hydrolase Cre knock-in and just published. And so by using genetic modification technique, so we have developed a model for the neurodegenerative disease or the neurodevelopmental disease and psychiatric diseases. And we can investigate the evolution of the cortical development. And we have been studying the phenotype of the genetic modifying Marmoset through the brain MRI and electrophysiology such as EEG, EMG, EKG, and also much electro recording, and also calcium imaging, PET imaging, and the behavior analysis, and also the molecular biology techniques such as the single cell RNA-seq. Okay, as an example, today I'm going to talk about the recent results on the Rett syndrome models. So mutations of P2 genes on the X chromosome were identified as the cause of Rett syndrome, showing the neuropsychiatric abnormalities, including abnormal dysfunction and the mild to the severe cognitive impairment, and the loss of the excitation inhibition and the EI balance in the neural circuit is recognized as a leading cellular and synaptic format that is fundamental to diverse the Rett neurological symptoms, and also molecular biology. Okay, so as MECP2 mediate not only the transcription repression, but also the transcription activation of the target genes. Okay, we generated Rett syndrome model Marmoset by the by the injection of the engineered nucleus, the zinc finger nucleus or the CRISPR-Cas9 into Marmoset fertilized eggs. So these engineered nucleus, they are target exon 3 of the MECP2 genes encoding methylated DNA binding domains. So through DNA double strand break and so non-homologous end joining, we can generate the MECP2 mutant marmoset. So far we have generated 16 MECP2 mutant marmoset, three heterozygous female, and 13 MECP2 mutant. So that included five female homozygous and also eight the male hemizygous. So these mutant showed that very early postnatal research, median survival 136 days. As regards behavior, it shows that reduced spontaneous behavior and also altered the preference for the social behaviors. We have examined the social behavior with the three-chamber assay-like system, and so individual marmoset was tested. So which they prefer the animal side and the object side. So the local to marmoset showed that different preferences for the social stimulus. Okay, as we have the structures, okay, we have the structure of brain connectivity by diffusion tests in imaging. And particularly, we have examined the cortical interactions. So this is the data for the 1 month, okay, 2 months, and 3 months. And wild type, and so MECP2 knockout marmoset. So this is connectivity matrix, and this is connectivity map. So you can show that at 3 months old, okay, you can see that obvious phenotype. Essentially, all the cortical region show that the reduced connectivity to each other in MECP2 mutant. This shows that the top 10 connections that show the biggest difference between the wild type and MECP2 mutant. Among them, medial prefrontal cortex show the biggest differences, and also visual cortex show that so big differences between wild type and MECP2 mutant. The question is how is underlying the morphological changes? So we have investigated these issues, the Golgi staining. This is classical method, but it is very informative. So this is this shows the dendritic arborization in the wild type and knockout. You can see that the dendritic arborization appears to be very poor in knockout marmoset. And so this is the result of prefrontal cortex. And so we have been quantitated by Schober analysis, particularly in the upper layer neurons. Okay, dendritic arborization was very poor in MECP2 mutant. And then what is the molecular basis for it? And so we have examined single nucleus RNA-seq from prefrontal cortex and also occipital cortex. This is UMAP plot, and you can see that cluster of the such as glia cell, astrocyte, and oligodendrocyte precursor cell, and oligodendrocyte, and excited various subset of excitatory neurons, and subset of the inhibitory neurons such as the VIP positive neurons, and somatostatin positive neurons, and pyrrolobin positive neurons. Okay, so we have examined differentially expressed genes. And so these panels indicate that genes downregulated MECP2 deletions. The number of the GO term related dendritic formation and synaptic formation is downregulated. And so these also identify the candidate therapeutic target molecules such as GABA-B receptor 2. I'll be back to this point later. But this is the consistent of the idea is MECP2 also acting transcription activators. Anyway, so we have examined cell types, specific GO the differential expressed genes analysis. So this shows that volcano plot for the excitatory neurons and somatostatin positive inhibitory neurons and in the occipital cortex. So you can see that lots of the neural function are related genes, such as synaptic timing ones, the MAP2, and so these are downregulated. In the MECP2 mutant, okay, indicating hypermaturation of the excitatory neuron and somatostatin positive inhibitory neurons. But somehow, surprisingly, we found that in PV neurons, these functionally maturation-related genes, such as synaptotagmin-1 and the other potassium channel and sodium channels, are upregulated. And this can indicate that hypermaturation of the PV neurons. So this may underline imbalance of the excitatory and inhibitories. Okay, so then we will examine the cross-species comparison of the differentially expressed genes and using the Rett syndrome, the human Rett syndrome patient, and MECP2 mutant marmoset and MECP2 mouse mutant mouse data. These are upregulated genes and downregulated genes. So we compared mouse and marmoset, and so there are a greater number of the overlap with the differentially expressed gene in the human patients in marmoset. It's larger than the mouse, okay, and for both upregulated genes and downregulated genes. And then also there's a higher overlap with the safari gene list. This is an ASD candidate gene list in marmoset. Okay, so and also we noticed that so the commonly downregulated genes include GABA-B receptor 2 again, and NMDA receptor, CDH8, and COX-2. So these are all of them very important genes considering the ST. And so these genes are interesting. So express differentially in the mouse and marmoset in expression site and timing. So all of these data indicate that MECP2 deficient marmoset are better model of the human Rett syndrome than the mouse models. Okay, then we have examined so comprehensive analysis of gene expression by the spatial transcriptome analysis. So we have examined so BGM analysis, and so we could see that so the clusters okay, corresponding to the layer formations, layer 1, layer 2, layer 3, layer 4, and layer 6, and white matters. So they show that a distinct gene expression profile. And so we found that, for example, FABP7 showed that a decrease in the MECP2 mutant in every layer, but the BDNF showed that so a selective reduction in the layer 2 series. Okay, as regards to upregulated genes in layer 2 series, we identified myelin-based proteins. It's known as oligodendrocyte-specific genes, but we surprisingly we found that upregulated in the excitatory neurons in the upper layer neurons. Okay, so, also we identified downregulated genes, GABA-B receptor 2. This is very important genes in considering Rett syndrome. GABA-B receptor mutations are found in the MECP2 mutation negative patient that is very similar to the Rett syndrome. Okay, so GABA-B receptor is a GPCR coupled with the GI that exerts a slow and long-lasting effect on neural development, maintaining a delicate balance of excitatory and inhibitory neural signals. So MECP2 and so GABA-B receptor axis would provide very important therapeutic target of the Rett syndrome. Okay, so if you summarize, okay, so the Marmoset database, we created a comprehensive integrated database of Marmoset brain, including MRI and tracer injection and gene expressions. MECP2 mutant, okay, so single nucleus RNA circuit transcript analysis has been done, and so this we could see the commonalities between the Rett patient and MECP2 mutant Marmoset. As a potential therapeutic target, we identified GABA-B receptor 2. Okay, so this results was done with my colleagues in the Riken, CBS, and Keio University, and also colleagues across the world, okay, including so my colleague, my friends in Macau Institute, Kopin Fan, and Bob Desmond. Okay, thank you very much for your attention.